Hey guys, so today we got Dallas' 2001 Chevy Silverado in the shop. Dallas just bought it and we want to make it our own. First thing we've been looking at the truck is we want to clean it up a bit. So we want to remove the body side moldings on it. Now this is one of those buyer beware kind of things. You don't always want to take these off depending on how you're using the truck. For us, we're willing to sacrifice a few door dings to make the truck look better, but these do serve a purpose. When you park in a parking lot, someone opens their doors and smacks this instead of checking out the paint. But this truck's so low now, all the dings are happening up here anyway, so we might as well just make the thing look better.
So, to do this job today, guys, we're going to use two tools. That's right, just two. Nothing special, but I thought it was time to invest in a heat gun. I've been using a blow dryer. This one's going to spew out up to 550 degrees Celsius. It's got a digital readout on the back to set your temperatures and three speeds. It cost me 40 bucks at the local Princess Auto. For Americans, it'd be like Harbor Freight, so pretty cheap stuff. The second one is my secret weapon, and that is this. Now I've heard that you can use dental floss, but my trick to it is fishing line. This is like 20-15 pound test fishing line. Works like a charm. We'll show you how to use this in just a second.
Alright, so some other stuff that you're going to need for this job. That's not necessary, but definitely needed if you want to keep your paint looking really nice. Paint clarifying compound. This is just turtle wax stuff. It's got a little bit of tooth to it, so it's going to buff out any scratches that you have after you take off your moldings. And there will be scratches. Those have been on there for God knows how long, well, 13 years because it's an old one, and there will be dirt behind them. The second thing we're going to use is Carnauba Wax Auto Detailer. Now, I'm just using this one because it was cheap. Otherwise, pick up a nice Carnauba Wax with some thick polish, and it's going to clean stuff up when you're finished. Other than that, just general purpose cleaner to clean off any dirt that's there before we start to wax it up. We don't want to have dirt in our wax because that's just going to scratch our paint.
Okay, the first thing we need to do is we need to reactivate the adhesive. What we're going to use is the heat gun that Dallas showed you earlier, and we're going to set it, we're setting about 100 degrees Celsius right now. For you Americans, just do your conversion, because I don't know what it is. Now, when you're applying the heat, just don't, like, put on the highest setting and then bang it on right there and hold it. Make sure you do, like, even strokes across it, that way you heat up the whole thing, because you don't want to bubble the paint underneath. Okay, what Dallas is going to do now is I'm just going to finish up applying heat. I'm going to apply a little bit of heat while he's doing it. It just helps if you keep it lukewarm, basically. It's not going to be super hot, but this way it's easier for the fishing line to cut through. And what you're going to watch is Dallas is going to come across here with the fishing line to separate the adhesive from the molding. Now, don't get any hot ideas where you think, well, I'm just going to heat it up and tear it off. It can work. I've just seen it happen a few times where because you're really pulling on the adhesive and it's not warm enough or whatever, it's actually going to pull some of the paint off or the clear coat off. Don't want to do that. So that's why we're taking the fishing line through to separate it first. And when Dallas is coming through, he's going to actually be going towards the molding. That way he's not digging into the paint because there is some dirt behind here and you don't want to be working that into the paint itself.
When I do come through, very nice sawing motion, get it in behind the molding. Start sawing. A little bit of pressure. Takes a little bit of time. Wrap around your fingers, and through she comes. And Anthony's heated up the panel so much.
Yeah, I basically put about 2 minutes of applying heat to this. So take your time. Be very patient with it.
If you get it too hot, you'll actually dig into this ABS, and you'll start to cut the ABS, and that's not what we want to do. It does come off in like almost a rubbery form. You'll see when you do it.
And it helps too.
And you will go through this.
If you have someone come on a really long piece, have someone come and kind of just pull it apart lightly so that way the fishing line can get in there more. And see here, if you use a little teamwork and as I pull it apart, it's easier for Dallas to keep moving the fishing line through. Good thing he has extra. Make sure you don't go ahead of the guy cutting off the adhesive. Okay, got the molding off, now we're on the second step. Now you can see here, there's a lot of dirt here and everything, I want to clean this off. So you might be thinking, like, it's going to be really clean when you take these off. No, dirt gets in there over the years. And if you lightly brush it off, there's actually some scratches in there. That's okay. It's just in the clear coat. That's why we have that polish in there. It's going to take that all out. But think about that. Like, over the years, these molding things actually act like sandpaper. That's why I'm not a big fan of the molding that goes onto the wheels. Because even more dirt gets in there. And you're putting salt and moisture from the tires and everything, and that's why it starts to rust. That's why I prefer not to have the moldings on the vehicle. Sometimes you have to run them when you run oversized tires, but that's kind of the downside to having moldings on vehicles. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this. Try to get most of that dirt off. Don't rub it into the paint. So now we've got the excess dirt off, and we go ahead and get rid of the rest of this adhesive. Okay, now for the fun part. To get this off, in this case, we don't have to do a lot of scraping or anything. It's coming off really nicely. What we have to do is we have to reapply heat again to reactivate it, and basically we can just rub it off with the finger. I'll just show you right now. See, I can apply pressure, and it comes pretty much right off. Now, not every adhesive is gonna be the same. It's not gonna come off this easy, but we're pretty fortunate in this case that it just comes off this easy. I'm pretty sure it's some sort of like 3M product or something. See, I'm just taking my finger. Now, if you don't really have calluses built up in your hands, you're probably gonna have a little bit of a blister, like you're playing like a video game for a while. Like, you know when you used to play Street Fighter and you're Ryu and you do like the Hadouken move all the time? Yeah, your thumb's gonna look like that.
Alright, I'm gonna show you guys the scratches that we're talking about. I'm gonna do a super close-up here. Please mind my camera work. And you see those? Those are basically the dirt rubbing with the fishing line and the dirt rubbing up and down in behind that thing. Yeah, they'll come out. Don't freak out or anything. And the top and bottom lines, those are the actual residue that's left over from the two-sided tape that's behind the molding. Now, Anthony's going to go ahead and rub that out with our paint clarifying compound, which is much just like, almost like liquid sandpaper. It's very high grit, and it's just going to buff those scratches out.
You said rub it out. Oh, I'm doing that now? Okay. So remember that polishing compound that Dallas showed you earlier? Really a scratch remover, any type of paint product that says scratch remover is going to work perfect in this application. And if you want to go a step even further, if you have a lot of residue, if you want to be really protective about the paint, use a bug and tar remover because that's safe for clear coat. So basically, you just apply it just like wax. You're going to have to put a little bit of elbow grease into it. So for the first application, we'll see how that turned out, mainly for the scratches. All those little scratches that were there before are pretty much gone. And then we'll do another application. And really try to work out the residue. Sometimes you might have to put your nail into the cloth or whatever you're using to really dig in to scratch or scrape off the residue off the paint. But just with this compound, we're definitely getting there.
Squeaky clean. Make it squeak. Oh, look at that.
See? Squeaky clean. Okay. Finally, what I like to do is to finally polish it. I usually prefer to use some sort of actual compound wax, like, you know, that's like a cream. But all we have is the spray-on stuff, but it'll do the trick just as well. And then just apply wax like you normally would. and this will help re-protect the paint underneath and everything, and just give you a nice polish. And because I'm lazy and impatient, I'm not going to wait for it to haze, because you guys probably don't want to wait for that. Not bad, eh? Like, it was never there.
Wow, you can tell we're Canadian. Not bad, eh?
It's like A, like a Hoosier A. It's like, you know, A, like West Coast A.
Just start saying mate. A? Not bad, eh, mate? Right all. Right all then.
Cheerio.
Gotta roll in the frame. Alright, so you can see that the back's finished. Now we just gotta do the rest of the truck. I'm showing you the basics on how to get all the moldings off on that one molding. We're gonna go ahead and take all the other moldings off and make the truck look uniform. Okay, so as you can see, we're all done. We got it all taken off, all polished on both sides. It took us about, 3 hours? Yeah, probably about 3 hours to do that job. Two tools, three polishers, and some shop towels. Now your eye doesn't just get chopped up with the molding that was here. You kind of go right to the ground this way, and you can still see this body line nice and straight. That also makes the truck look taller, which in turn makes the truck look lower. So that's a plus side without actually even touching the suspension or anything to do with the truck's height. Cleaned it up. I like this aesthetically a lot better than before. And nice clean molding now.